It's time now for Sunday brunch, and joining us this morning is Kevin Miller from Copper Kitchen. Good morning.
Good morning, Jennifer.
You are going to make us the ultimate in Sunday brunch comfort food.
Yes. I love cooking in the fall. And you have apples and pumpkins and all these great spices and stuff. We're doing a caramel apple crepe this morning.
You're doing everything from scratch.
Everything from scratch. A crepe is so simple. It's just a thinner version of a pancake. It doesn't have any leavening agent. Mm-hmm. It has a lot more milk and a little melted butter and eggs. We're going to use a blender, because the blender is really the best way to do this.
So blender or juicer, if you have it.
Blender or food processor.
Okay.
Really. We have milk and water, 2/3 cup of each, 3 eggs.
All right.
A little bit of sugar, pinch of salt, flour.
Sounds like a hot tub bubbling
It's so
quiet. I like that.
This is like the Rolls Royce of blenders.
It's really nice.
It's a Vitaprep. It'll juice, too, so. This
your
is the
job,
best way
you have
to do
have
it.
The good stuff. All right, so you mix it up.
Yeah. You want to let this sit for an hour.
Okay.
Before
so it sort of thickens?
Well, no. Actually, it helps. What you're doing now is you're developing the gluten and the protein, and it makes it tight.
Okay.
So you want to just let it loosen up a little
bit. All right. Meanwhile,
we have a pan going here with a little bit of clarified butter. Use a non-stick, preferably.
Or a
crepe pan.
And now,
the consistency should look like heavy cream. The magic of TV, yes.
Okay.
Swirl it around like that.
Right.
You want to just swirl it,
so
just
to coat
it. Just to coat it.
Is that a cast iron skillet?
No, this is a
just a regular skillet.
Yeah, okay. But this is I've had this for like years.
You've got it aged.
It's just well seasoned.
It's looking good.
So, we have some apples going in, a little bit of butter and sugar.
All right, and you just want to get them to their soft.
You don't even want them that soft, but depending on how you like them.
Mm-hmm.
I like them just a little bit of bite, but we got butter and sugar in there to caramelize them, and then we're gonna make a quick pan sauce. It's so simple to make your own caramel. Don't buy those caramels. You never know what's in it.
Although it's a pain to unwrap
them
all.
Yeah, sometimes there's high fructose corn syrup and all that other stuff in it.
Okay.
It's not, it's so simple to make it.
All right, so you've got cinnamon and sugar
mixture.
Look at that,
great, beautiful.
And you put some brown sugar in there.
Uh-huh. Pinch of salt. I like a salted caramel.
All right.
That salt really brings out the flavor.
Now you're just mixing them over the apples.
Uh-huh. We have a little bit of heavy cream here.
Hey, meanwhile, your crepe crepified really well.
Yes.
It did its thing.
It could go a little browner, but it's nice.
Right.
You can make these a day ahead of time, and you can stack them all up. They won't stick. Put them in the refrigerator and pull them out and heat them up.
So this is like good for maybe Thanksgiving morning, too.
Absolutely.
Or just any
and there's so many things you can
fall.
Do with. Oh, yeah, there's so many things you can do with crepes. We have a plate of crepes right here, which I've made this morning.
Do you want me to bring them over to you yet?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll bring them over.
Look at that.
Okay,
can you
substitute different things other than apples with this? Can you go ahead and...
Drizzle some chocolate, some bananas.
Oh, yeah.
You can caramelize some bananas
even.
And brown sugar like a Bananas Foster. That's
All right.
awesome.
If you would like a copy of today's recipe, go ahead and log on to our website, WBALTV.com, click on food, or send us a self-addressed stamped envelope to Sunday Brunch, WBALTV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, Maryland, 21211.